Here, we're going to see the process for creating a new lot in inventory. You can do this under the inventory responsibility, under transactions, and go down to your miscellaneous transaction. This is a very common transaction for adding or deleting material from stock. Here we're going to do a simple account alias transaction, a receipt. When we go to our transaction lines, we're going to input a lot controlled item. We'll receive it into stores, and we'll tab over and put in a quantity. Once we have that information, we can come down to our lot serial form, and we can input our lot numbers. We could use an existing lot that's in stock if we wish to add material to that lot, or we could create a unique lot that hasn't been in inventory prior. So in this case, we're going to split our inventory. We have a quantity of 100. I'm going to put 50 into lot 12. I'm going to come down one line and put the remaining 50 into lot 13. Once this is complete, I can hit done, and then I can hit save to execute the transaction. Now, to make sure that I have completed what I intended to do, I can go to on-hand quantity, input the item, find, and I can go into the drill down into stores, and I can see there are three different lots of material within my stores sub inventory. I could also change this and go to the lot group, and I can see my lots in this form and fashion as well. And of course, you'll see the reflected quantities over in this screen. And that's how you get lot controlled material into stock. Through any of your standard receiving processes, you just have to have a lot controlled item created.